Hey there, Angular folks, it's Brian. Angular recently released something pretty neat, a new debugging tool that changes everything about how we understand our applications. It's called the Signal Graph, and it was introduced in Angular 20.1 just a few months ago. As Angular developers, we're often debugging in the dark. When you click a button, which components update, which signals recalculate, what's the order of operations? We've had to use console logs, breakpoints, and a lot of guesswork. Well, not anymore. Let's check it out. First, you'll need Angular DevTools. If you don't already have it, grab it from the Chrome Web Store or Firefox add-ons. Just search Angular DevTools and hit install. I've already got it set up, so let's jump straight to the fun part. Let's see how it works. I've built a really simple counter app that we can see here. We'll use this app to see how the signal graph can help us troubleshoot and pinpoint issues. To access it, you need to open your browser's DevTools and then find the Angular tab. If you don't see the Angular tab, make sure you're running your app in development mode, not production. Now, the signal graph is currently an experimental feature, so by default, it's not enabled. To enable it, we'll need to click the settings icon here and then turn this on. Perfect! Now we can use the signal graph. The first thing we need to do is select the component we want to explore. In this case, it's pretty easy. We only have the counter component, so let's select it. Then, we just need to click this button up here to show the graph. Beautiful. Look at this graph showing all the signals in this component. Let's trigger some changes to see it in action. When we click this button, see how the signals light up? That's showing us exactly what updates when we interact with our app. We can see the signals blinking. That means their values just changed. Now, you may be noticing the different colors for these signals here. These are different colors because they represent different things. The blue boxes are just standard writable signals like the count. The green boxes are computed signals, values that calculate from other signals like this double value. The purple boxes are effects. These handle side effects like logging or API calls, for example. This red box is a linked signal, which is a writable signal that can update based on other signals. It's essentially a writable version of a computed signal. And then this gray box represents the template. Then the lines between these boxes show how data flows from one signal to another. Think of it like a family tree, but for your app's data. From here, you can click on any signal to see more information. You have the name, then the type. In this case, it's a computed signal. Then you have epoch, which represents how many times this signal has changed since the app started. And then you have the current value. In this case, it's 0, which we can see here in the UI. So if I select another signal, then click the button, we can see both epoch and the value updating. Now here's where signal graph becomes really valuable. We just saw that the double value is 0 and it's only updated once. This double computed signal should be based on the count signal, but we don't see a line connecting them, so this lets us know we have a problem. So when we click the button, if we watch what happens, double never updates like it should. Let's open the code for this component and see if we can see what's wrong. Okay, here's the double computed signal. And here's the problem. Instead of reading the count signal to get the current count, it's using a hard-coded 0. That's why it's always 0 times 2, which equals 0. And this is why there's no connection in the signal graph. In this case, the fix is simple. Let's change this line to actually read the count signal. Okay, let's save and let's see what happens now. Perfect. Look at the signal graph now. Now we can see a line connecting count to double. The dependency has been created correctly. And when we click the button now, both signals blink. And the double value updates correctly in the UI now too. So, there it is. Signal Graph turned our debugging from guesswork into crystal clear vision. We spotted a broken dependency, fixed it, and instantly saw the proof. The more signals your app has, the more powerful this tool becomes. So give it a try. It's like switching on the lights in a dark room. If this saved you some console logs, hit like and subscribe for more Angular deep dives. Until next time, thanks for watching.